Yes. Good morning, students. So now today we discuss here what is the power of lens. In previous video we discuss about refraction through the lens, how the refraction occur via concave and convex lens, and we discuss number of ray diagrams. When object is placed at infinity, what is the nature of image? Similarly, when object is placed beyond the 2f, then what is the nature, size of image? Now on the basis of their behavior we define here power. Each lens have some power. So power of lens, power of lens means here the reciprocal of focal length. This is called here power, that means ability. So power is defined by P is equal to 1/f. 1/f means reciprocal of focal length. This formula is in meter, okay, but same formula is to be written as P equals to 100/f. This is in centimeter. Okay, so this denotes here power. If we talk about their unit part, so unit of power, unit of power, so unit of power is to be defined by here capital D, and this indicate here diopter. So diopter is the unit of power. We can easily define, if suppose focal length of any lens is 1 meter, then we can say its power is said to be 1 diopter. Okay, next we see here combination of power of lens. This means here when number of lenses are recombined. For example, if we recombine one convex lens, have focal length suppose f1, after that one concave lens, its focal length is suppose f2, and one more suppose convex lens of focal length f3. So obviously different focal length, that means each lens have different power, p1 suppose p2 and p3. So resultant is to be given by again p word, that is power, and this is sum of individual power of each lens. So p1, p2 and p3, and p1 means 1/f1, 1/f2 and 1/f3. So this denotes here resultant power. As we know that we have two types of lens, convex and concave. So we have two types of length. If we talk about focal length, so for convex lens focal length is to be positive for real image. Similarly for concave lens focal length is to be negative for virtual image. So power is reciprocal of 1/f. So here focal length is positive, so power is also positive. That means for convex lens power is always positive, and if we talk about concave lens, so power is equal to 1/f and f is here negative, so power is also negative. That means we may conclude that here for convex lens power is always positive, while the concave lens power is to be negative. And if we find the resultant, when two or more than two lenses are there, so we easily take the sum of individual power of different lenses. So this denotes here power. Thank you everyone.